Topic of discussion is bronchodilation, and it's a very important topic. First of all, we will be dealing with the definition, the two most accepted definition for the cyst. One is the by Kelly and Kay in 1966, and the other by Kramer in 1974. So basically, both of them have the same content. That is, says that cyst is an abnormal cavity in heart or throat tissues which contains fluid, semi-fluid, or gas. Is often encapsulated and lined by epithelium. Whereas the Kramer's definition in 1974 says that this is a pathologic cavity having fluid, semi-fluid, or gaseous content that is not created by accumulation of pus but is always lined by epithelium. So that is how we differentiate between a cyst and an abscess, because invariably a cyst will always be lined by epithelium. Now coming to the classification of diagnosis. We can classify broadly into odontogenic. Odontogenic from the word itself, it means arising from the tooth forming tissues, and non-odontogenic means it is developing from tissues outside the tooth. It can either be a developmental anomaly or a fissure anomaly. And now coming to the classification by etiology, and that is the developmental cysts. Must be knowing a few of these cysts. One is dentigerosis, one is eruption cysts, odontogenic keratosis, lateral condylomatous cyst, etc. And also the other type of cysts are what are known as inflammatory cysts. So the inflammatory cysts, we get periapical cysts, residual cysts, and paradontal cysts. And the other is the classification by tissue of origin, that is derived from the cysts that are derived from the rest of melasis, which include the periapical cysts, residual cysts, dental cysts, etc. And this is derived from the dental lamina or rest of series, which includes OKC, Williams cyst of newborn, Williams cyst of adult, etc. And finally, unclassified cysts,